I have intentionally turned my mic down and my headphones way up, so I'm going to try to avoid some of the breathing that I have been doing as of late. You ready to light this puppy?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, here we go. The T-bone.
And chick proof.
Let's God bless all these years. Just get it right one time.
What do you want from me?
40 years they've been trying. You couldn't fire somebody if they were horrible, doing a terrible job for the veterans. And now you can say you're fired.
Okay. No one listens to radio.
And now for a quick disclaimer. The T-Bone.
And Chick Brew.
Show is brought to you by nobody. We have no sponsors.
The show is still rated G.
For glorious.
Even if I were to find the original audio of me and you going back and forth to do that, the little montage slash clip thing I got there, I don't think I could recreate it. I think what we have there is beautiful, and I know that it's wrong. I know we've changed the name of the show. I got it, but I like it.
Yeah, I do too. I word mouth along the words. It's comfortable. It feels at home.
I don't know if we're going to be able to do this. You're probably every other word is coming through.
I don't think I could get any closer to this microphone. Maybe I can.
Well, you are talking to it sideways instead of straight on.
I know, so I have to.
So when you talk directly into the microphone in the way that it's designed to be spoken into, I hear you great. And I bought you one of these little things right here so you can adjust it.
So it melted.
What?
It did. It did. It melted a little bit. So I can talk straight into it, but then my headphones. I can sit like this. It melted a little bit.
It is not that hot there. What did you do? There was flame involved somehow.
No. This is a flame-free house.
Then how did it melt?
Wait, what if I pull? So, oh God. Everything's fine.
Everything's fine.
I don't know, it's fine. So, it's very hot. And the pads, that grip, because I had it on the shelf directly in front of me, and that was really nice. So the pads that grip, they melted while I was gone. I have been looking, and I think I have found silicone ones to replace. I just haven't placed them out of order. And I need to, because Amazon started recommending the silicone pads to me, and we all know how I feel about buying things that Amazon recommends or Facebook recommends. Facebook recommends all kinds of stuff.
So I just hit the button there for echo cancellation, and you're talking into the mic, and it sounds really good. To let you, well, and then it didn't. So we'll struggle. Oh, we'll struggle through this.
Same setup. How does it change?
I don't know the atmospheric conditions. I don't understand. We are 6,000 miles away from one another. So there are some...
Never keep me from you.
There are some challenges that we should be expecting, of course. But it's also 2023, and we should be able to communicate with one another right now. Better than this. Because we're making a quality product here. And I don't want to hear complaints, and I have heard complaints about sound quality.
Kick rocks.
No, I want their complaints. I want their feedback, and I want to do better, and that's why we try to do better all the time. We do not have a large audience, but we do have a very loyal audience. When it comes to the superfan competition, there's actually competition for being the superfan. You never know if it's going to be Mike Stanley. You never know if it's going to be Mr. James Taney. You never know if it's going to be Teagan Lapping. You don't know who it's going to be, but there's a potential. Sometimes Shirley Magwood might slip into the mix, but you know, football season's coming, so we're gonna lose her. That's pretty much a rundown. We've never nominated any of our family members for a fan of the week. That's strange that we haven't. I guess they just need to be engaged.
We are the new Hollywood, so we might as well start with the nepotism. So if it's a kid, it's a nepo baby, but if we like fan of the week our moms, is nepo mommy?
Ooh. You're just making up words right now. Nepotism is up and down either way,
right? So if it's a child in Hollywood, they're like, oh, you're a Nepo baby, right? Like, that's the new thing, is to call out everyone who is just continuing the family business.
I don't have enough Hollywood friends to know Hollywood slang.
Well, you have the TikToks. You should know these things.
I got some TikToks in the book is of the books of faces. That sounds like it's straight out of Game of Thrones.
The book of faces. So, while I was waiting for you to join me in the studio, I pushed all the buttons on the board you gave me.
Uh-huh.
Now, growing up, everyone was like, oh, you must be Tommy's sister. And I was like, how did you know that? But now that we're older, I feel like we look a lot alike. And I pushed this button.
And then I was like, that's my brother's voice.
Oh, my God. Are you not dying?
What? Did you see my face? That is exactly your brother's voice.
Is it not? So all I did was push the male button. I won't do the female button because that is terrifying. But I pushed the male button and I was like, oh, it's like talking to my brother, but me, which was also, I guess, scary, really, when you think about it.
But think of the fun you could have the next time you call your mom.
There will be pranks. There will be cards with the voice recorder made and sent.
I'm going to need some money. Chris, mom, I have to tell you because Christina's pregnant.
Don't even put that into my universe, uterus, none of it.
Ah, the fun that could be had.
It's scary though.
Fortunately for me, I don't have any sisters to torture. But you know,
if you hit the female voice, I'll do it just because
it is. What? Why is that the female voice?
No, that's no good. I've got the voice thingy here, but every time I've tried doing it, it's always caused some kind of complication.
No, don't do it.
Yeah, I just avoid it altogether until one day I figured out I do enjoy my Stream Deck. My Stream Deck gives me a little push button options that I like because I understand that it is quite temperate in your penthouse studio. I am in the basement. The AC has been turned off because the AC handler's right there. And I got a couple million watts of lightage on me right now. So you will see me sweating alongside you as we move through today's episode.
I lost 5 pounds on recording the podcast.
Did you get a chance?
Put on my sauna suit. We should be like wrapped in saran wrap. We should look like freaking sausages right now.
No,
we should be making the most of this.
Never again. I've never have to wrap my body up in saran wrap again. So we got a lot of things going on. We haven't talked in a little bit because there's been a lot of things going on. So tell us all what's going on over there on the western coast of southern Spain. What's going on in your world?
Well, the temperature did come down a little bit, which has been really nice. Spent a lot of time in the pool. My cousin left. All of our house guests have actually left. You want to hear? So who gets COVID anymore, right? Like the manager came back from the States and immediately the next day had COVID and then was quarantined. So I've been spending the last like week sleeping with the dogs on the couch.
And waiting on her hand and foot, I'm assuming.
Yes. No, I did. I did all the things. I bought the cough drops. I bought the NyQuil. I force fed the NyQuil. If people are asleep, they can't complain. But
true story.
Is better, which is great. Yeah. Just take this. But it was great because we actually celebrated 6 years of holy matrimony. Marital bliss. And she did. She surprised me.
Oh.
She took me on a romantic outing and it was freaking amazing.
Oh. With more COVID on top?
No. COVID was gone. It was fine. Everyone's fine. But there's a company out here called Southern Picnic Company or something. You'll see them on the pages. We chartered a boat with a picnic and games, and we went out into the ocean, and they took us out right under the Cadiz Bridge, and we just like putted around the Bay of Cadiz. It was perfect. Water, of course, was just as calm as you could ever have hoped for it to be. No one got seasick. It was a beautiful day. I don't think so, but I do tend to fall asleep places where things are moving.
There is no better sleep. I will say this to the day I die. There is no better sleep than sleeping at sea. The gentle rocking motion while you sleep, you don't get better. You get into, and now it's all cruise ships for me. But you get into a stateroom, you got that air conditioning just cranked, and you got a couple of libations in you, and you're just gently being rocked to the port, to the starboard, to the port, to the... Hey, go!
So I have a Whoop, right? And it tracks, like, different things, like your stress, whatever. But my stress tends to be, like, just high all the time. Even when I'm asleep, I'm, like, mid-grade stressed. We were on that boat. The entire time we were on that boat, my stress level was like flatlined. It was non-existent.
Interesting. I would like to have a thing that measures my stress level, because I am.
It's been fun.
I am. I'm really, really good right now. As I was telling somebody today, you know, people think my job is crazy, that there's craziness going on in my job. I'm like, no, you don't understand. I just escaped the asylum. I was in with crazy. There was a whole bunch of crazy. I know crazy. This ain't crazy. This is like kindergarten. That's the freaking loony bin. I had to think of the degrading term to call a nut house, because there's not enough apparently. I escaped the loony bin, and this is like daycare. It doesn't even come close.
I love that for you.
Yes, me too. But I don't have a Whoop. Because if I had a Whoop,
I might be pondering a career move.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Well, I have a little more research to do, but I will absolutely keep you and everyone updated.
So, Ron Cain and Damien Robinson, they got the DNR podcast that I listen to. You know, it's local comedy scene stuff. And the last two episodes in a row, Ron's come on like, yeah, I got a lot of interesting stuff going on. Can't talk about it. Thanks. You tease.
It's the very, very beginning. You know, like, I have to research everything. I don't like to just jump, especially when, like, you're a grown up and there are other people relying on you and blah, blah, blah. That sucks. Like, yeah. You can't just be like, I'm going to do this. So I'm making some, but possibly soon.
You miss 100% of the shots you don't take. That's what they say, right?
Right, right.
But so are we talking drastic? We're talking.
Yes.
Okay. I mean, you got a lot of things going on. You got a lot of plates up there spinning.
No, and I think that I need to. I think I could just use like two plates. You know.
I agree.
Two is good.
Two is good.
Would be great, and then like one other thing.
One is good.
Yeah, but I mean, I want to stick with the reserves. I want the retirement. I also would like to make chief. Also, big shout out to my friend LSC Select Questa. Just found out today that she made, she was selected for chief.
Yes, those reservist chief results just hit the streets. Yes.
Well, you know, you might frown on it, but she's been downrange. Like she's been active. Not like me, reservist, where I'm like at home mustering people. Like
I am not frowning upon it. Why would you say I'm frowning upon it?
Because I can actively see your face, and that dimple is deep right now.
Yes, because I'm smiling. I just dig her name, Questa.
I know, Sandra Questa.
Yes,
she's a fantastic person.
All right, well, good for her. Congratulations. Yeah. You know, the active duty list isn't coming out just yet, which is strange because tomorrow's August the 1st. And I know they've moved the timeline around ever since COVID jacked everything up. But, you know, I was well into the reindeer games at this point in 1999 when I put on my khakis. Couldn't hear a word you said. It all came out gargled.
I was in high school.
Okay.
You were a busy boy.
Yeah. I hadn't gone over 11 years yet. I still had 10 years in. I believe it was a Friday. I think it was a Friday. I'm pretty sure it was the 23rd. You know, that's funny. It's funny how things work in life. So... we always call 23 a lucky number because it's, you know, my wife's day of birth. So I would watch her dad throw money down at the roulette table and he would put it on 23 and I'll be daggone if it didn't come in, man. Those were some nice days. So I didn't even put those things together, but I'm pretty sure it was July 23rd, which is right on spot with being the birthday. And that was the day I found out I made chief. I was 2 days short of my ending my 10 years and beginning my 11 years. And again, this is 99. It wasn't very common to make chief that quickly.
Yeah.
And I had no idea that I would stay a chief that long.
That's what it is. It's a bottleneck. The closer, like the higher up you go, it's just like a stranglehold.
Well,
people don't want to get out of the way.
there were worse places I could have been stuck. That's for sure. So being the same pay grade for 12 years, well, that'll teach you some patience, teach you some manners.
It's funny because when I switched from active duty to the reserves, I missed like 3 exam cycles because no one could figure out that they just needed to order me an exam. And there's no other MCs, obviously, in my unit. And active component take theirs when we're not there. So I couldn't split a test. And I was just like, well, I'll never make first. And then I took it once. And I got very close. I think I missed it by like 2 or 3 points. And then during COVID, I took it in Rota instead of in Italy. And that's where I made it. So I'm like, how do I take my chief's exam in Rota? Every advancement I've ever made has been...
Yeah, you got to do it there.
I can't do this somewhere else. Like, this is my safe place.
That's your good luck charm.
This is where I'm comfortable. Rolls off the back. Yeah. But I am up for it. I probably should have actually taken it last cycle, but I didn't go to drill because it was too expensive.
That's about as backwards as that actually sounds. You say you missed it by a point or two. I missed first class by 0.2 of a point.
Oh, that's the worst. And no NAM in the cards for you, huh?
Well, turns out there was. So...
Well, it turns out that I had actually had a flock while I was at AFN, but no one from AFN sent it to me, so I never had it put in my record because I got it right as I left. So I would have actually advanced to first on that first test.
My chief at the time, I was in Charleston. My chief at the time, his name was Brian Daly, and he said, "Come with, you know, very stern. Come with me." Roger that. So up and away we go. We go to the smoke pit. He goes, "I got good news, I got bad news. What do you want to hear first?" I was like, "Come on, chief, you know me. Give me the bad news." He goes, "You didn't make first." I was like, "Oh, that's okay. That's why, you know, 6 months from now, I'll try again. No big deal." He goes, "Well, do you want the good news?" I was like, "Sure." He goes, "You give me that 20 bucks you owe me, I'll make you a first class." Well, I had 20 bucks on me, but I couldn't think why I owed him 20 bucks because I don't borrow money from people. But I pulled out that 20 bucks and I handed it to him. I was like, "Well, make me a first class." He goes, "I already did. And you don't owe me any money." I was like, "All right, that's a win-win."
When I found out I made first, I was actually in culinary school in New York. It was the same day that the manager had come from Spain to visit, summertime. And I had actually been not in trouble, but I was having issues, right? Because everything is constantly changing as far as access, and my cat card expired during COVID. But no, for a reservist, they're like, "We don't care if your cat card is expired. You're not getting in this office to get a renewal."
Yeah, you'll be fine.
Fine. When I get to the States, I'll find a place to get it renewed. Like, no problem. It's fine. I don't care. No. It took me like 5 months at 2 trips to Long Island, out to the like peninsula. And several taxis and trains to finally get it renewed and updated. I got it renewed and updated. And 2 weeks later, manager comes. But my chain of command had been like kind of on top of me. Like, "Hey, you need to check your email." I'm like, "Hey, I can't. No CAC." "Hey, you need to log in." Says, "Hey, I can't. No CAC." Like all these things. And my master chief calls me. And I talk to my master chief like very rarely ever outside of drill.
The way it should be.
Right. That's perfect. That's absolutely perfect. But the chief I had was retiring and I was like, "Oh, she's probably calling to like, let me know that she'll be taking over. I will now be her responsibility." But no, she was like, "I just want to make sure this was the right phone number. The CO is going to give you a call in a minute." And I was like, what? And I was like, mind you, I've never met this man because we did the change of command over Zoom. I don't know him. I just know the internet version of him. I'm like, okay. All right. Yeah, no, that's fine. It's fine. It's fine. It's fine. CEO calls me and he's like, hell yeah, you know, I love the story, blah, blah, blah. He's talking about like all this other stuff. And he's like, also, I just want to say thank you so much, MC1, for all the hard work you do. And I'm like, oh, I was like, I'm a second class, sir. And he's like, second class? Really? Are you sure? And I was like, oh yeah, no, I'm a second class. And he's like, no, you advance. You're first class. And I was like, oh. And then it made sense. Like, why would my master chief call me to tell me the CEO was going to call me? Like, that made no sense. But it all happened in 5 minutes, and I was distracted.
So, telling my sailors that they had advanced was one of the perks of the job, if you will, okay? I take the time to train them. I prepare them. They advance. I notify them. And then somewhere over... I remember one time, man, Sam Arma, he just made second class, and he was one of my sailors, and he's a good kid, and I was training him. He was in my training division. He was smart, and he makes second class, and I want to tell my sailor congratulations. I want to be the one to make that notification, and some other second class just decided that he was going to take it upon himself to let my sailor know he had made rank. I can't tell you how mad I was on that. And I let him know too. You didn't do anything for this. All you did was share information you had that it wasn't yours to share. But then, you know, and that's the kind of leader I was, that's the ownership I had on my sailors. But over time, the CO started making it a point that they had to be the ones to tell the sailors that they made rank. Why? Why do you need that? Did you do anything to build these sailors up? Did you do anything to train them, to prepare them, to take on these roles of greater responsibility? No. And you're going to get your photo with them. You're going to promote them.
Actually, that never happened. I didn't actually get promoted. We showed up for drill, and I had asked Warrant, I was like, hey, would you mind, you know, putting my rank on? And she was like, absolutely. And then she's like, I'm actually not going to be there. And then I was just like, okay, fine. So I literally just went to the next, bought one, threw it on my business, which is so on brand for my Navy career. My first reenlistment, the MC who was taking pictures didn't have a memory card in the camera. There's literally no pictures of that. But, you know, I didn't really mind because I didn't know that Master Chief that well. Like the one, the SEL we had had before, I liked her. She was like a mentor. She helped me get all my stuff together, if you will,
right,
when I switch. Because active duty there is a huge...
Well, either we lost her. Yeah, I think we lost her. So she'll figure it out.
Fine. You could have called me. That would have been great.
Oh, there she is. She's back. So you locked up, and you locked up like this.
Oh, cute. Because you locked up with your hand on your hip.
Of course.
Very sassy, yes.
I'm a little teapot. Ladies and gentlemen, we apologize for the sound issues. You know, every week we try to give you a quality product, and we might be missing the mark this week, but bear with us. There's something in here somewhere. Yeah, so anyway, as I was saying, these COs are now taking away, like, one more thing from actual leaders, from the leaders that are actually doing their job. They've taken away one more of those benefits. And when it comes time to retire, you'll know. I had asked that question for years. When will you know it's time to retire? And all of my mentors... all of my mentors said the same thing. When it's time, you'll know. And they were spot on. And I've told everybody that ever asked me since, when it's time, you'll know. And it was really... It was getting time because... That was one more thing that was taken away from me that I earned. I earned that notification because I put the time in. And then because they're the CO and they just, for their own freaking ego, for their own, oh, look at me. I'm the guy that gets to tell the guy. You know, it was just one more thing. It was like, it's time. It's time to go.
So for us, like, it really comes down to who wants to tell the person. Like, our unit is... I love my unit. I am not great at being in the Navy. We all know this. I am not really the best reservist by far. But the people in my unit, I love, because it's probably one of the most respectful and cohesive military organizations I have been a part of. And like our SEL we have right now, she just went back to the States, but her and Questa have a great relationship. Christina Mahar is amazing. She was our SEL. She just PCS'd. She's one of those leaders that will go to bat for you every time. You can message her any time of day. She will get back to you immediately. Love her. And even though she's not really our SEL right now, we all know that she should be the person to tell her. And I'm an admin. I knew right away because I'm an admin. I'm on the email chain. But
it wasn't yours.
I waited 5 hours. I was like, I've known Questa for like since 2018. I've known her longer than anyone else in the unit. And I was like, oh my God. And then my chief came back and said, she knows. And I was like, oh my God. But I, you know, you have to wait. And it's not even that. It's like, when you think about these things, it's like, who is going to mean the most in that memory for them? Right. Like, I remember being pinned by some people when I was advancing. And I honestly, like, that's not a good memory for me. But my reenlistment when I was in Bahrain, that's probably my best Navy, like, stepstone memory. Because the people who pinned me during my advancement, never my family, never my loved ones, always people from work. It's whatever. But the person that reenlisted me in Bahrain, one of the best people I know. Hasher, you would love her. And and the group I was with, I loved them. And it was the place where I said, thank you all for coming out. I like 6 of you. I'll let you figure out which ones that is. And there was like 12 people there.
When I put on third class, I was down in Alabama. And I'm sorry Grandma. for the squeaky noises, but he wants to play. And he...
we love dogs and we let them get away with anything.
My father had come out. I had graduated military police school, and I was going to be promoted to third class at the graduation. And my family had come out, and my dad's old school Marine. And he decided to put $50 on the table for anybody who could drop me while they were tacking my crow on. Tacking a crow on, for those of you who are not into military parlance, the third class petty officer rank insignia is a crow mounted over a chevron. And when you put that on your shoulder to make sure that crow doesn't fly away, people line up to punch you. And he put $50 on the table to anybody who could drop me while they punched me. And again, different time, different place. This is all happening.
I'm so glad that one went away. I just don't understand, like, the point, it sounds so stupid. That's a boy thing. It's 100% a boy thing.
So it's occurring on stage. On stage, they are lined up to punch me in the shoulder or in the arm. And I remember
I might get in, actually.
And then we get to this one person who I just absolutely could not stand. I couldn't stand her. I hated everything about her. I hated her existence. And she came to punch me. And I remember, you know, I'm just a brand new third class. Brand new third class. She's a first class. And I'm like, no, not you. She goes, what do you mean? What do you mean, no, not me? I was like, yeah, you don't get to punch me. This is not for you.
This is not about you.
Yeah, keep moving. Oh, if you thought she hated me before, she absolutely hated me then. But yeah, she did. Dad didn't have to give up his $50. Nobody dropped me. Monty Hedges, man, he almost won that money. I almost took the fall just so my dad would have to pay that money. This is back in 1990 when $50 was real money.
You could have bought a whole car.
You could buy a house for $50 back in 1990.
Thanks for the down payment.
But we would always do, you know, we'd always try to do something special whenever one of our guys made rank. We'd always, you know, I remember taking them up to the top of a building and yelling at them about something horrible that they did. And then it's always that, you know, last second misdirection there. Like, I don't know how as a first class you're going to be able to get any of this done, you know, when they're a second class. It was, we always had fun with it. And they took it away from me. And when you start taking away the fun things at work, you don't want to go to work anymore.
Yes.
So.
No, it's true. It's true. And I think, like, I have never served close to where my family can be for any of these things. They've never watched me. Even when I enlisted in the Navy, it was a work day. Like, my dad was in, he was in court in Houston. My mom worked for USAA. Like, no one was coming. They've never seen me enlist. They've never seen me re-enlist. They've never seen me make rank. So I need to, like, really figure out, if I make chief, like, they better get over here. I better, like, start saving some money. I mean, I think I have time. I haven't even taken it once. I'm up for it this cycle. I highly doubt I'll make it. I think they're only doing 10 reservists, but 33 active duty MC chiefs. Did they all get out? They all left. That's a lot.
That is
normally
quite a bit.
It's like six. So I was like, literally everyone made chief this time. That's awesome. I love that for them. And I am now terrified that next cycle's numbers will be back to two.
Hey, at least there's two. I mean, I know many, many cycles back before MC became a thing, when you had your JOs and your PHs and your LIs, and there would be zero.
That's CBs now. They are locked up tight. Oh my gosh. They're like in long-term prison over there. I feel so bad.
Well,
for them.
And they didn't make it better. They thought, by creating the CB Master Chief. So there's always been rates. There's a couple of rates. Two of them are CB rates that at the E9 level, they were combined. And this was because you didn't have enough and the numbers and the flux and the wildly complicated way of saying, we don't have enough people here, so we'll convert them into this if there's the opportunity. And it was always tight in the CB rates. And then a couple of years ago, there's like, you think that's a good idea? Hold my beer and watch this. And then they decided to combine all of the rates up at the Master Chief level to be this thing now called a CB Master Chief, which I don't think turned out the way they wanted it to turn out. It, like the road to hell, it was paved with good intentions, but they are the senior, senior people in the CBs that I know are not happy.
It's always like, was it Corman? They have terrible advancement.
What are you talking about? Corman, first of all, you have to remember, Corman are
There's so many of them.
Yes, they are the largest.
Running around.
They are the largest rate in the Navy. There are more Corman than there are any other rate in the Navy.
You get Motrin. I actually had a really good experience with a Corman recently. I had to go to the doctor.
Well, I've had some particularly great experiences with Corman. Some of my best friends are Corman. My best friend is a Corman, or was a Corman. So
he's pretty good.
All right. Well, sound quality be damned. We're going to push on through and get through the rest of this show. I think it's time we, we're definitely.
Bring Audrey to the other side.
Yeah.
Lots of songs.
Do it again, except with the man voice.
Break on through to the other side.
Boy, he is some kind of needy today.
Well, today we're going to go for a walk. It's my second workout of the day. Earlier today, we did tries, buys, so we're going to go for this walk and see you guys tomorrow.
I was doing something else and I thought you were playing a video of him.
I nailed it.
Wow. Hey, let's just go to the Wheel of Destiny because we haven't done that in a while and I don't feel like making a decision today. The Wheel of Destiny landed on
It is time for a resolution rewards update.
It landed on a segment we no longer do. I am going to have to update the Wheel of Destiny.
How have your workouts been going?
I haven't been working out. Remember we talked about that last time.
Yeah.
Yeah, still.
Are you doing any stretches? Nothing? How's your everything going with that?
Well, it's been getting better in the last couple of days. But I've still got some doctor visits going on and still trying to I'm still trying to get better, but I haven't been doing it on a treadmill. Moving on. Today we go to the Book of Everything. The Book of Everything is where we learn something. Yeah, you may have learned a lot today because, you know, we've been talking about the Navy. A lot of people don't know about the Navy, and we've been sharing some insights on leadership and retirements and all kinds of things. You could have learned something already, but this little segment we do here is specific to learning obscure facts. I don't even know what the rest of this is going to be. They had me at young Neanderthal girls. Oh, here we go. Young Neanderthal girls had bigger biceps than an adult male human. I like them real thick and juicy. That's interesting. You don't really think much about those. You don't think much about those young Neanderthal girls, but there you go.
Yes, here we are.
This one will give you nightmares.
Oh, no.
As soon as tiger shark embryos develop teeth, they attack and eat each other in the womb. The shark doo 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 baby shark doo 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 baby shark doo doo
doo doo doo doo doo ate my sis. Ate my bro doo 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 mom. What happens in there?
In the womb.
Oh my god. I'm sweating even harder now than I was. So and like every time I have really bad cramps, I know you want to hear this, is my favorite part. Every time I say, oh, it feels like I'm giving birth to a baby rhinoceros. But now I'm going to say,
baby tiger
I
shark.
Obviously have a uterus full of baby tiger shark.
I like it. Making analogies better. That's what we do here at the Lunsby Show. Hey, you got any headlines for me?
Of course I do.
And now it is time for headlines from around the globe.
It's a sad, sad day in the world of television and movies. Paul Reubens has passed away today. And I don't think you're going to have a headline about that. I'm going to say he was a funny guy.
He's very funny.
And he did some amazing things. Pee-wee's Playhouse was really some kind of special. It really was.
It was one of those shows, like, I've rewatched some of Pee-wee's, like, Playhouse as an adult. It was great as a kid, very entertaining, but it has aged well. It was funny and enjoyable again as an adult.
Yeah, it could play
like,
today.
Not. Yeah, like, yes, some things not the same, but that, still good.
Even Pee-wee's Big Adventure plays well today.
Yes.
Sorry on the passing of Mr. Paul Reubens, but that's not the headline you got for me. You got this one for me.
Domestic rabbits invade Florida suburb thanks to illegal breeder.
Domestic rabbits take over a Florida suburb due to a domestic breeder. No, it's not due to a domestic breeder. It's due to the fact that rabbits are very good at procreating.
They breed like rabbits.
They breed like bunnies. It's kind of what they do. It's what they're known for. And if you release them into the suburbs of Florida, where there are no natural predators,
rabbits are the new kids zoo.
They're going to bunny hop their way into a nuisance category. The easy thing to do, and this is where we as humans always screw up, the easy thing to do is to bring in a predator to the rabbit. Because that's really all you need to do, right? If you have a rabbit,
I'm a big ranger.
If you have a rabbit problem, then you bring in an animal that'll kill and eat the rabbits. And then,
have you ever butchered a rabbit?
No, I haven't. Have you?
Okay, yeah, a few times.
And it's not that she's a psycho serial killer, ladies and gentlemen. To remind you, she is a chef.
If once they're skinned, if you look at their front legs, where that meat is, it's not actually attached by anything except for like the like sinew. There's no like muscles connecting or connective tissue other than like, it's super weird. How do they move their front legs?
Yeah, I don't know.
So this week, I'd like you to go to the store and ask for an unbutchered rabbit. And then I'd like you to take it home, call me, and I'll walk you through it. And then you give it to Zeus, and he'll be the happiest boy ever.
Yeah, I'm not doing that. First of all, I've never seen that as an option at my local Giant. Come on in and get an unbutchered rabbit.
All of the Amish people, they got a fresh rabbit.
They don't even sell rabbit here. I remember because
go get one, Mr. Pew Pew. You got the guns. Go get yourself a rabbit.
Italian word for rabbit looks a little offensive. It looks like a bad, bad word. If you were shopping for meat in an Italian grocery store and all you saw was the Italian word for rabbit, you probably wouldn't want to buy that. Or maybe you would. Depends on your inclinations. But luckily, they put pictures everywhere. So anyway, back to the absurdity of this headline. You got a rabbit problem. You bring in the natural predator. Ooh. You bring in the natural predator to the rabbit. And once they consume all the rabbits, then you're going to have that problem. So the easy thing to do next is, of course, bring in a predator to the predator. And you just continue the cycle until eventually.
Florida, the predator? Like, I feel like there's snakes and alligators and humans.
Why would you steal that from me? That's exactly what I was building up to. That's exactly where I was going with my rant. And then you're going to end up with crocodiles, alligators, and giant snakes. You stole that from me.
Because the anaconda don't. Anaconda don't want bunnies if you got loves, honey. They're not doing it.
I had that wrapped up. That was going to be a good one. And you,
it was going to be a good one, but you know what? I am the plant from hell. You didn't even have to ask, but I'm right here with you.
You got another headline for me?
Of course. Enormous Lebanon bologna sandwich unveiled at Pennsylvania Community Fair.
All right.
This is your people.
These are my new peoples. These are the peoples I've chosen to be peoples with. Lebanon's right up the road. I've been up there a couple of times. I don't know what Lebanon and bologna have to do with one another, but it's a fair. There's probably some alcohol involved, but you said it's the world's largest bologna sandwich?
The title is enormous. And I'm looking at the picture and it is got some girth to it.
Like human size or just like a big old sandwich?
It's bigger than humans.
When it comes to bologna or bologna, which is the funny way of pronouncing the word bologna, it's still spelled bologna, but for some reason we call it bologna. How do you like your bologna?
At the deli where I'm not eating it.
Oh, because you don't like bologna.
I'm not a fan of packaged meats like that. I call them rubber meats. I haven't liked them since I was a child. Everyone feel bad for my mom. School lunch was a nightmare.
Oh, everything with you. You don't like the eggs. You don't like the chickens. You don't like the bolognas.
Nope.
You can't take your medicine. Oh, I would have choked you out as a child.
I'm certain that she would have also liked to do that, except for she is better than me, so she did not.
I'm a fan of fried bologna.
Oh.
Yeah, it was kind of a...
Is it cubed and sliced?
No. Kind of a ghetto treat. It's old Oscar Mayer. Just take a slice, throw it in a frying pan, and watch it turn into a bubble. And then you put that down with a little bit of mayonnaise. And usually, you couldn't afford any more accoutrements. When you're eating bologna sandwiches, you're worried about paying the rent. You're not really worried about, I wonder if we got any cheese for this sandwich.
Well, now I understand the heart conditions. Wonder Bread, mayo, and fried processed meats.
I mean, Wonder Bread, honestly, look, when I was...
It's delicious. It's delicious, all right?
I couldn't afford Wonder Bread.
Oh.
Yeah, I'd go like to the day old bakery. And when they're selling bread that's sliced from the day old bakery, that's not day old bread. That's like a week and a half old bread.
Yeah.
It's got like a day before the mold gets to it. But you
it's
can
a day before it is used to fill crevices inside the mortar of your apartment building is what that is.
Yeah, those were the days. But sometimes you had to stretch your budget, and that's what we do. You eat daggone bologna sandwiches. How was it before?
I'm going to try the sandwich.
Oh, a plain old bologna?
Yeah, I'm going to try it. I don't know when. I have bread currently. I can make mayonnaise, and I'll buy bologna.
Yeah, you know, the cheaper the better. Like the cheapest. Yeah. Like if you can get like the 69-cent bologna.
I'm going to go to the commissary. So it'll be $80. but that's probably the only place I can what you're talking about.
Or 2 weeks ago, it's all running together now. We asked the audience, hey, how do you cook your corn? And we did get some responses on that. And it turns out that you're not crazy.
I know I'm not. Who boils corn?
I boil corn.
It's got the juice.
apparently, no one else does. Apparently, I'm the only person that boils corn. But I mean, don't boil corn anymore because I own an Instant Pot. But I used to. And I used to do drugs. I still do, but I used to too. That's a great joke. I miss.
You've graduated from boiled corn to normal people corn.
Normal people corn. Well, this week's question is another food related question, ladies and gentlemen. How do you like your bologna? Does it have a first name? Is it OSCAR? Does it have a second name? Is it MAYER?
Because Oscar Mayer has a way with.
Oh, no, you were doing great. Keep going.
Yo-L-O-G-N-A. Bologna.
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 Bologna. All right. Yeah. So there's our headlines for this week. There were some other headlines out there that I thought you may be sending my way. There was a person who chopped off his wiener unintentionally. That's going to be a bad day. Then there's a guy who buys a $15,000 dog suit and wears it around pretending he's a dog.
Oh, no, I watched that video. It was, you know what, no judgment, but the face was scary. Also, I was a little mad because he wants to be a dog, but then he was being carted around on a cart. No, bro, you've got to put in the steps.
Once upon a time, I bought a pretty awesome wolf costume for Christmas. I was my wife's accessory at a Halloween party. So I have this huge wolf costume, and I test it. I put it on, and I send her a message, you know, come to the room. And I was very, very clear. Do not let Zeus in first, because I'm a giant wolf in the room. And I felt like that had a potential of going really bad.
Because he's her guardian.
Yeah, nope, she let him right in.
Good boy.
And he tried to kill me till I got that face mask off and showed him that I wasn't a 6 foot tall wolf. I was just daddy in a wolf costume.
He's so good. He was like, I don't care. I'm doing it. I love my mom and I will protect her at all costs.
Hey, let's talk about cooking. Well, we kind of were. Let's continue talking about it.
It's time to talk about cooking.
And tonight proved one thing. You know f*** all.
So other than enormous, girthy bologna sandwiches, what else have you...
Awful.
What else have you been working on?
So I tried a new cupcake frosting idea, and it mostly worked. I was trying a different frosting recipe, but I think if I made it with my regular frosting recipe, basically what I was trying to do was make a hidden tie-dye pattern inside the frosting. So I took black icing and then I put my normal rainbow icing in layers on top of the black icing. And then I rolled it so that when I frosted, you'd see like little hints of the rainbow. But when you bite into it, it would be like tie-dye in the middle. And it came out very close, but I was using some different products than I normally use, and the icing wasn't as firm as I think it needs to be. So I'll need to adjust some of my products. But it was super cool. I mean, you bite into a cupcake that's like mostly black on the outside, and the center is like neon tie-dye. Can't really go wrong with that. I'll try to show you a picture.
Oh, just share it on the page. Oh, that looks disgusting. I realize your creative side says that's beautiful, and that did not look pleasant at all.
It, it didn't really do what I wanted it to do. Like I said, the freeware, and you know, there's no air conditioning to cool anything down. So as I was butter splits and I'm just putting it back in the refrigerator, pulling it out, it was a mess. But I think I can do it. I just need to make some adjustments.
Okay. I have a story to share when it comes to food. Let me ask this. What's your best chicken marinade?
But it depends.
Okay. It's just some nice grilled chicken. You're just eating some grilled chicken breast for dinner. How would you marinate it up?
I do have like a nice jerk chicken that is good on the grill, or a five spice is also good.
The boss lady likes to use Italian dressing.
Italian dressing.
Yeah.
That's easy.
Take your chicken, throw it in a bag, throw some Italian dressing in there, and let it soak for a day or two. It's real nice when you do it that way.
Yeah.
But I think she's trying to poison me, because tonight's was...
Again?
No, she, you know, and she gets so mad, and I don't know why. I still eat all of the food, clearly, but she gets mad when she doesn't hit a home run every single time she steps up to the plate, figuratively and literally. And, you know, even Babe Ruth struck out a couple of times. And this wasn't, there was just something in, it was Italian dressing. We already know that works. And then she mixed in some like Fuji apple or something like that. And it just gave it this strange taste where it was not as delicious as it normally is.
Apple?
No, it's like a Fuji apple salad dressing.
Oh.
Mixed with the Italian salad dressing. And it
just. They're two different acids.
They're two different acids. And it tasted just like that. It tasted like two different acids. And she beats herself
like
up.
A Friday night acid and a Tuesday night acid.
Too. Yeah, they don't go together. You don't mix those.
Commit.
Yeah, one or the other. Do you ever do any chemical cooks? A friend of mine.
Not Breaking Bad, my friend.
A friend of mine was able to do chicken with tequila and lime juice. And
you will not find me messing around with chicken like that.
And it went from raw to edible just soaking in these liquids.
Yeah, I mean, it's like a ceviche, whitefish, salmon, shrimp. But even still, you should parboil that stuff to kill off bacteria.
Yeah, I agree. I thought it was strange, too, but there may have been some alcohol involved and, you know.
If you ate it?
Well, if you have a little...
I wonder why the heart conditions are a thing.
All right, enough of that. No, I'm done with you. I'm done with you.
Just like that?
I'm done.
With me?
No, him.
But Zeus is precious.
Because he won't stop. He won't stop. He won't stop. And I have to say no. I have to say enough is enough. And that's what I have just done.
Can't stop. Anyway, so you ate the weird chicken.
Yeah, I ate the weird chicken, and it was good. I mean, I don't remember getting sick from it, but I've never been brave enough to do that myself. I would think I would enjoy doing it again, but maybe with shrimp or fish or something where I wouldn't be as worried if it didn't turn out right.
Like even in school, like, and you know, we go to restaurants. It is what it is. You don't know how they're going to prepare it. But even in school, especially the shrimp, because the vein is right there and things can get caught up underneath the shell. Not so much with a whitefish. Whitefish, that will cook very easily with lime juice. But with the shrimp, it's very highly recommended to get a pot of boiling water and just blanch them just to shock the bad right off, and then you just scoop them right out, and they're not cooked through, but you've done enough to like get rid of ickiness, and then you finish the cook with the lime juice. But what? I don't like chicken enough to be trying to not die with some tequila and lime juice. I'll put the tequila and lime juice straight in my belly and put the chicken on the grill.
That does sound fun, doesn't it?
That sounds also, too, like a waste of tequila, because that tequila is now like salmonella shots.
But you can't just you microwave it.
Oh, my God, I'm going to die. You might not have gotten sick off of that, but I am trying not to vomit.
As I thought of all the chunky little raw chicken bits in the tequila juice that got microwaved, I also started to get a little sick in the mouth.
How drunk were you? Was this like a week ago, or was this like college days? Because college was a weird time, and that's kind of excusable.
I did all my college while I was in the Navy.
So this was last week.
No, this was Sicily. This was Andy Dorfman and his crazy chicken.
Is Andy Dorfman still with us today?
I'm sure of it. He was a
bring him on the show.
Tough old bastard.
Put on your Nielsen pants and hunt him down.
Speaking of tough old, I recently started, my friend Pat, who we've talked about in the past, has recently taken some of his best sea stories and converted them to YouTube videos.
I love that.
And Pat has some amazing sea stories. And there
actually was an idea for a podcast I had while I was active duty. Just sea stories. Just finding different sailors and having them come tell a sea story. But instead, I live with you and every day is a sea story. Now we got to start doing sea shanties. That would be great.
What's a sea shanty?
Like weird melodic songs.
Oh, you weren't considering doing sea stories by calling them sea shanty. If anybody out there, you know, we've offered up the mic many times over. If you got a rant you want to do, we'll give you 5 minutes. If you got a sea story we want to tell, we'll get, you know what? If there's anybody out there that's got a sea story they want to share with the Lunsby audience, not only will we allow you to do that, but I'll make a really cool intro for the sea stories. Pat is a great storyteller, and he has got some great stories that, you know, and it's been 20 years since me and Pat were stationed together. I may not remember all the details of some of his stories, but overall gist of it, I get. Yeah. You know, I remember the story, but it's I didn't remember the details because it wasn't my story. So he has taken to YouTube, and he has started to tell some of these stories, and they are great stories, and I'll maybe share a link with the audience of one of the ones that I had never heard before, but I'd heard recently. And I think the audience will appreciate a good sea story from a silly old bubblehead living down there in Southeast Georgia. And that's going to be fun to do. Meanwhile, back at the Justice League.
Over here.
Justice League. I don't know.
I don't know. You know who I saw?
I know we've talked about Pat on the show before because I remember specifically doing a birthday boost for him and then following up with that after he had done something like, hey, after that birthday boost, he turned his life around and whatever. So he has been talked about. He's great people. He's got good stories. I'll share the link. I think the story that I'm going to share from Pat is one I think you will all enjoy. This is our birthday boost segment. If you have a birthday during the week that we are taping, we will give you one of two things. We will either grace you with this wonderful thing called a birthday boost, or if all else fails, we'll give you a honorable mention. Birthday boost, if we're going to say wonderful, amazing, incredible things about you or not. But it's going to be done with the intent of boosting your ego. And honorable mentions, well, if you don't want to be an honorable mention next year, try harder, suck less. As always,
be better.
Yeah, as always, you go first.
So this is my best friend's mom. You know my best friend, Melissa. Her mom, Jeanie, is celebrating her birthday. I can't believe that's the age that she is. I won't say it, but good. She doesn't look that old. Jeanie, was, you know, yeah, like the fun parent and then like the strict parent.
Of course.
Jeanie was like the ultimate fun parent. So she was the one that was always like, take us shopping. Didn't really worry too much about like the curfew so much. she was the fun parent out of my four parents, which were Jeanie and Bill, Melissa's parents, and then Tom and Jan, my parents. I had four of them growing up, and I think that was almost enough to get the job done. But anyways, Jeanie is out living her best life. She's retired. I don't know why she hasn't come to visit me yet, but it is what it is. I love you, Jeanie. I promise I'm on my best behavior. I look forward to seeing you maybe sooner rather than later.
Once upon a time, and I guess because we're just talking about memories and, you know, when I made Chief, I put on Chief down there in beautiful Puerto Rico, and I was on deployment. And the Master Chief, or the Command Master Chief, or VP-26 at the time, was a young man by the name of Roger Dumont. Roger Dumont was probably the epitome of what leaders were supposed to be. He was a great guy. And he is retired. I have retired. But it doesn't mean, you know, thanks to Facebook, I still get to live life vicariously through him. And one of the accolades I so admire is the love he has for his wife, Bonnie. They just celebrated, I think, their 47th anniversary, and he is going to celebrate his birthday. And he is an amazing example of an amazing man who I have the best memories of. I love this man, and I love the love that he has for his wife. And with that, I couldn't give you a bigger, a brighter, or a better happy birthday, Mr. Roger Dumont. Who is your second birthday boost?
Master Chief Misty Flynn. She was a senior chief when I met her at the schoolhouse up there in Fort Meade, Maryland. And she's just an amazing mentor, but also very chill, down-to-earth human, living her best life out in Hawaii right now. I think she's about to retire, which is kind of devastating because, I mean, for us, not for her. That's great for her. But you know when you have like those good leaders and you're like, don't you want to just one more enlistment? And they're like, no, literally, I have zero left. That's like where she's at. But I love her because, one, she's hilarious and she's always got the good memes and the funny stories. But two, I haven't really spoken with her in quite some time, but I needed some assistance on Thursday of last week. I shot her a message like, hey, hate to bother you on Facebook about work stuff, but do you think you could help me out? Boom. Yes, this is what I need from you. I need your email. Oh, here's my email. Fantastic. Not even 10 minutes later, Senior Chief from the schoolhouse in Maryland messaged me back. So me in Spain messages Master Chief in Hawaii, and 10 minutes later, Senior Chief in Maryland gets back to me. Amazing. Not everyone would do that for a random MC1 reservist over there. But she always comes through. And it's going to be a sad day for the Navy, but a great day for her. So happy birthday. Come visit me too. Door's always open.
Very, very well done. That's exactly how a birthday boost is going to be done. I am on a theme this week for my birthday boost. I already gave out Roger Dumont his birthday boost only because of the extreme love for his wife, Bonnie. And I'm going to continue that trend when I think of my friend, Misty Cotton. Because Misty has been the ride or die of my friend, Howie, for years and years. Now, I don't know how many years they've been married, but I know they've been married a long time. And I know they love each other immensely. And the love that they have for each other is something that I feel special. So they just bought like a old school or something and converted it into this amazing bed and breakfast. And it's been really fun to watch. And it's not far.
Is that on the TikToks or the Facebooks?
It's on the Facebooks. It's on the Facebooks. Oh, yeah. We've got to get more details on it.
I love those things. I'll watch that for like hours.
when they open up for business.
By the time I'm done, they'll be monetized, okay?
When we open up for business, I'll be sure to share that information. But as always, Misty Cotton, wishing you nothing but the biggest, the brightest, and the best. Happy birthday to you. Now moving on to those honorable mentions.
Man, it's just a very Navy day, I guess. Lauren Howes, you know.
Yes,
Lauren.
Yes, I have her too.
Jordon Del Gardino.
Uh-huh.
Tony White, Ron Brown. It's a lot of Zachary Shea, Lier Gonzalez, and do you remember Dr. Sonja Waters?
No.
She was here. Oh man, she was fantastic. I don't know if she's retired or not, but talk about a woman who knew her stuff. She was over at the hospital. Brilliant. Brilliant medical mind.
Right? If you got tiger sharks in your belly, she knows what to do.
Someone knows what to do because I am at a loss. I can't now.
My honorable mentions this week are coming from the Mijas, Miss Elisa Jimenez Bermudez. Yes, Matt Nally. Oh, Dirk Diggler himself, Mike Parsons. Terrence Poppinwell. I don't know if you remember Terrence, but he looks just like Wayne Brady. And I had him and I had Mass Chief Wilkerson, who looked like Kevin Hart, in the same mess. They were so fun to have around. Sean Parsons, Joe Allen, Megan Lopez, Crystal Hogan. What? You didn't have
Wait,
Megan?
Is it the Megan Lopez that I, from Rhoda? That's in Italy now?
Megan Lopez? Yes,
Megan Lopez?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. No, I didn't have her. I mean, Joshua, I didn't look.
Joshua Bramhall, Jeremy Marco, Latonya Starks, who took down her picture. That's strange. Tim Bray. Haven't been yelled at by him in a long, long time. Skye Ashley, Artie Fletcher, Phillip Mackey, also known as Rock Paper Sexer, and recently retired Mass Chief Jeff Wright. An amazing group of people, and we wish you all nothing but the biggest, the brightest, the best, and the happiest of happy birthdays. Well,
I want to tell you, I got to hang out with Paul Thomas III.
Did you get to hang out with Paul Thomas III? Was this before or after he locked himself out of his vehicle?
I don't know. I drove his vehicle, so he had keys at the start and stop of that. But it's been really great to kind of see him around a little more frequently. We should definitely bring him on again.
She wants to bring him on again, and I don't have a problem with that. I don't have a problem with bringing anybody on again, and we say this all the time. If you want to get into the Lunsby audience, you want to get into their brains, you want to get into their heads, and you got something you want to share, whether it be a rant, whether it be a sea story, whether it be a sea shanty, if you got any of those things you want to share, just reach out to us, DM either me or Christina, and we'll get you on. We'll record it special for you. We'll find a time that works for you. We'll get you in. We'll get you out. It's a good time to be had by all. Ladies and gentlemen, I remind you today, as I remind you every day, just be the best person that you can be, and if you are a great person today, be an even better person tomorrow.
And don't forget that you are loved.
Thank you for listening to T-Bone and Chick Brew. If you enjoyed that show, you should check out the Darrell McClain Show, independent media that won't reinforce tribalism. We have one planet and nobody's leaving, so let's reason together. You can find the Darrell McClain Show at the same place you actually listen to this show. Give it a shot.
All right. That's a good show.
Cool.
Some audio difficulties, yeah, so, but other than that.